Here is a law that you might think is barking mad and might lead you to have your collar felt, and following all the rules might not be a walk in the park. I'm talking about the Control of Dogs Order of 1992, which I bet most of you have never heard of, and moreover, you've probably never heard of this requirement in so much detail, or the offences that it might carry, and the consequences that might follow if you don't follow the rules. So here it is. So Section 2 of this piece of legislation requires that every dog, while in a highway or in a place of public resort, shall wear a collar with the name and address of the owner inscribed on the collar or on a plate or plate badge attached to it. Now, the majority of you canine loving folk out there have probably got a little name tag of your beloved Floof with your phone number on the back of it. But how many of you, and be honest and let me know in the comments, how many of you have actually got your name and address of the legally registered owner of said Floof? I'm betting it's not that many of you. But failure to comply with said rule under Section 3 provides for an offence, which reads: the owner of a dog or the person in charge of a dog who, without lawful authority or excuse, proof of which shall lie on him, causes or permits the dog to be in a highway or in a place of public resort not wearing a collar as prescribed in Article 2 above, shall be guilty of an offence against the Animal Health Act of 1981. In English, this means if you breach this law and said Floof does not have these details on the collar or name tag, you could face summary conviction punishable by a fine not exceeding level 5 on the standard scale. Remembering, of course, that a level 5 fine was previously capped to a maximum of £5,000, but for crimes committed after the 13th of March 2015, level 5 fines have been done away with, and all criminal penalties expressed as being punishable on summary conviction by a maximum fine of £5,000 or more, or expressed as being on a level 5 fine, are now punishable by a fine of any amount, meaning unlimited. That's because anyone guilty of an offence under the Animal Health Act of 1981 is punishable by summary conviction on a fine not exceeding level 5 on the standard scale. But not only that, and whilst you might be a little bit miffed about the £5,000 fine, it's Section 4 that will probably alarm you and have you running to your nearest pet store. Section 4 is rather shockingly titled Seizure of Dogs. This reads: any dog in respect of which an offence is being committed against this order may be seized and treated as a stray dog under Section 3 of the Dogs Act of 1906, or under Section 149 of the Environmental Protection Act of 1990. Now, whilst this might be a very old law, bits of it are still at play, including part of Section 3 of the Dogs Act of 1906, which includes the seizure of stray dogs. However, if all of that wasn't strange enough already, let's jump back to Section 2 once more of the Control of Dogs Order of 1992. This is where it gets a little bit strange, barking mad if you like, but subsection 2 of Section 2 provides that this rule shall not apply to A, any pack of hounds, any dog being used for sporting purposes, any dog while being used for the capture or destruction of vermin, any dog while being used for the driving or tending of cattle or sheep, any dog while being used on official duties by a member of Her Majesty's Armed Forces or Her Majesty's Customs and Excise and Revenue or police force for any area, any dog while being used in an emergency rescue work, or any dog registered with the Guide Dogs for the Blind Association. Now, I'll go back to my question earlier and please answer honestly. How many of you that own a dog have the name and address of the legally registered owner of said canine? And please also let me know what you think of this law in general, and please remember to like this video and subscribe, and of course, thank you for watching.